Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome back to our channel once again. I've always opined on this platform that in politics, nothing happens out of mere coincidence. And that everything in politics is normally well-planned, well-scripted, and executed to achieve a specific political objective. Nothing in politics just happens for the sake of it. William Samoei Arap Ruto, the President of the Republic of Kenya, will tomorrow lead the nation in celebrating Madaraka Day. The event will take place in Bungoma. But George Natembeya, the Nzoia governor, has been denied the invitation. He's an unwanted guest during that Madaraka Day celebration. And the question which we should be asking ourselves, why would George Natembeya, the governor for Nzoia, be denied the invitation to attend the event? Because normally, leaders are normally invited. So in this video, I want to reveal to you guys the dark secrets behind the move to deny George Natembeya the opportunity to attend the Madaraka Day celebration in Bungoma. But before you do that, for those who are watching this channel for the first time, please take a second or two, click the subscribe button so that next time we produce a video like this, YouTube will automatically notify you. And to the subscribers, I want to continue thanking you guys for your continued support, because without that support, this channel cannot be where it is. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, allow me to dive in. Why do you think the organizers of the Madaraka Day celebrations in Bungoma decided to lock out the Nzoia governor from attending the event? Because earlier today, Natembeya, while addressing the residents of Nzoia, made the revelation. I want you guys to listen to Natembeya before we proceed.
Understanding the people the truth.
Yes.
Yule mtu ambaye anasema anatembea anadanganya achukue podium aseme ulisema hii ukasema hii ambayo ni uongo. Na nitasalimu amri. But because wanajua anasema ukweli, kazi yao ni vitisho, vitisho, vitisho. Hata wakati rais anakuja bana, wanaitana mimi ya wajiji. Magama na bana wengine wanaitwa sisi. Eh? Hata tukutoa wakati ya kwenda sherehe kesho mimi nimekataa. Lakini hao viongozi wacha watembee kwenda wakifinya mimi watakuja hapa ground watapata kuna watu. Watapata tulienda, si ndio? Maana barabara yao imetupeleka Jangwani, tunatafuta barabara hii. Kwa ukienda Kisumu zimekuwa city. Mombasa na hivi hapo. Na niende upinzani. Sasa sisi Raila tunamwagia kura nini pia kuja tumwagie best friend. Hapo ndio sisi tu.
So that's George Natembeya. He's very clear that he's not invited, that he's unwanted at that particular event. So why would someone lock out George Natembeya from attending the Madaraka Day celebrations? In Bugoma, why? The truth of the matter is that in politics, everything is normally intended to achieve an objective. Let me ask you this question. What do you think is William Ruto's game plan for 2027? Because based on the political development in the Republic of Kenya, William Ruto's game plan for 2027 is going to be different totally from his game plan of 2022. In 2022, William Ruto's game plan was very simple. Have IBC. Of course, he will have IBC again. Then focus on the mountain, Rift Valley, and try and compete with Raila Odinga in some of his strongholds like the coastal region. The difference between Ruto and Raila at that time was around 200,000. The truth is, that's why the gubernatorial elections in Kakamega and Mombasa were suspended. In 2027, William Ruto's game plan is going to change completely. Because the mountain is running away from William Ruto. The truth is, if elections were to be held today, Ruto cannot get the 3 million votes he got in the mountain. And I doubt even if he can get a half of what he got in the last election. The ground is slippery. And Rigathi Gachagua is also clearly a man on a mission. If you've noted, William Ruto has been camping in Bugoma since yesterday, today, and tomorrow is the main event. Traditionally, the president would have arrived in Bungoma tomorrow. So which means there's something which is really disturbing the president. In fact, I was shocked yesterday when I saw the president posting on his official handles, you can check there, that he had launched, he had officially opened. Is it the Webuye West Technical and Vocational Training Center? Something which has been in operation for years. But let us not get into that. Let us focus on why Ruto has allowed the organizers of the event to lock out George Natembeya. Number one for me is the demands by Mudavadi and Wetangula to Ruto. You know, Natembeya has put the toe in a very tight corner. He's pushing them out of the Luhya politics. But the two are the eyes of the president. The president believes in Mudavadi. He also believes in Wetangula. In fact, for Mudavadi, he has even agreed to fold his party. So William Ruto is trying to fold Ford Kenya, which is really giving him problem, and the ANC party to join Kenya Kwanza, or UDA for that matter. But Natembeya is coming up with a movement which is taking the Luhya nation by a storm. So that has caused a lot of panic in Mudavadi and Wetangula. So during their meetings with the president about this particular event, I'm 100% sure that one of the conditions they put on the table for the president was one: we don't want Natembeya to be part of this. Because if anything, there are people who have been accusing Natembeya of being a project of William Ruto to checkmate Wetangula. So the only sure way for Wetangula is to ask Ruto to stop Natembeya from attending the event. And that's exactly what has happened. They demanded that if Natembeya is coming, we are not coming. So basically, they have used Natembeya to blackmail William Ruto. So the question is, for how long are they going to do that? So that's number one. Number two, there's also the fear of Natembeya stealing the show. You see, tomorrow is going to be a very big day. The leaders are going to be there. I'm sure based on what I've gathered, the ground is going to be mobilized because William Ruto want to send a very strong statement. So assuming the ground is well mobilized and people are full, you know, some would just want to go and attend. I'm sure today the airs in Bungoma were just choppers, military choppers training there. So people will attend because this is probably the first time it's happening in Bungoma. And then Natembeya comes there. The crowd erupts. When he leaves, the crowd erupts. Do you think that would be good politics for Ruto? Do you think it would be good politics for Mudavadi or Weta? So I think someone probably might have advised William Ruto based on intelligence report that George Natembeya was going to steal the show. So the best thing, please just keep him out of the event. Number three, the Tawi movement. If there's one thing that is going to stop Mudavadi and Wetangula, is the Tawi movement. That Tawi movement is gaining the momentum. And the fear is that majority of those who are pro-Tawi movement are anti-government. So you cannot expect William Ruto as the president of the Republic of Kenya to go there and easily just accept the leader of Tawi movement to also be present there.
It's not tribalism. I am completely incapable of being a tribalist. Lakini ukikuja kuongea masuala ambayo inahusu jamii yako sio ukabila. Jana jamii ya Mount Kenya yote ilikuwa Limuru. Limuru 3, mimi walikuwa na Limuru 1 na Limuru 2. Na wakapanga masuala ya jamii. Ukienda kule wa Masai wanaendanga mahali inaitwa Suswa. Wanaongea mambo yao kule Suswa. Ukienda kule jamii wa Kalenji huwa anaenda mahali inaitwa Kapkatet. Kwenda kuongea masuala yao. Sisi Waluo huwa tunaenda wapi? Huwa tunaenda watu kuongea masuala yetu. Watu ambayo ni 7.5 million population ya Kenya. We are completely disorganized. Na mimi watu yetu, hakuna siku nimesema mbele ya watu mimi nikatukana mtu. Huwa situkani mtu. Lakini kuna watu ambao wamelelewa kwa maisha tu ile ya blue band, atukimwambia ukweli, aenda akasirike, anasema umemtukana. Hiyo sio matusi. Nyinyi mwana vila askari wamejirotisa hapa. Mesikio majina ya namna gani? Mekuwa na Jerotit, na Rono, na Kipuruto. Hiyo ni makosa. Mwemesikia mamujasikia. It is the truth. It is the truth. And this country we must confront the truth. Wakati mamba haifanyi wiva hakuna balance. I do not expect mama kutoka hapo Sokomoko, aina ambie DIG kwamba huku kwetu hatujapata nafasi ya kutosha. I expect our elected leaders, wale viongozi watu ambao kule mbele ni Wetangula na Moses Mudavadi. They are there. Mimi nikisema hivi wanasema niwapatie heshima, maana mmoja amekaa miaka 40 huko, mwingine 30 years.
What of if they will start talking certain things? Of course, with the Ruto, you can't rule out lying. And then the people will start saying this. Wanafanyanga hivi ama aje? They normally do it. Is it this way? Dawe wanafanyanga hivi ama hivi? I think inafanywa hivi. And then the crowd starts doing this way. While Ruto is speaking. He can't allow that. That is the fear that the Dawe movement, the presence of Natembeya might influence it on the ground. Number four is crowd management. For those who participated in politics, especially the ones which are run by the government through the provincial administration, crowd is normally managed. So assistant chiefs, those village elders will be told, you come with this number of people to the stadium. By this time. So I'm sure right now, there are people who are already in that stadium, just waiting for the gate to open. They're just hanging there. Yeah? So Natembeya was going to come with his crowd. But while these guys are managing the kind of crowd, their people, because they know huyu anakonga mtu wa Tawe, huyu ni mtu wa Raila, huyu ni mtu wa Ruto, huyu ana msimamo. So kama wewe ni mtu wa Ruto, wewe hauna msimamo, you are brought. Then the rest are locked out. But if you give room for also, because the governors are also normally given the opportunity to mobilize their supporters to attend. Now, Natembeya coming with his supporters, unmanaged, terrible. And lastly, I'm also looking at an elaborate strategy to isolate George Natembeya, so that down there, the topic will be about Ruto, Mudavadi, and Wetangula. No any other person. In fact, you can also argue that the other reason why he's being isolated is because they want to isolate him strategically and portray him as not part of the Luhya nation. They want to portray him as part of the greater Rift Valley. Because remember, as much as Nzoia is predominantly Luhya nation, they are part of Rift Valley. I don't know what you think. That's my take. But I think that is petty politics. Until next time, this is Lee McQueen. Bye-bye.